you a bit about entrepreneurial Jen, because so many people probably know you as being a model, and that's kind of the main thing that you're known for. But obviously you've got Aussie and J-Bron and property and so many other amazing entrepreneurial ventures. And the more I looked into you, I was just like, this woman has got to be on the cover. She's just the most incredible entrepreneur in Australia. So what do you think it takes to be an entrepreneur?
Firstly, thank you for having me on the cover.
Oh, my pleasure.
Honour. So I read your magazine prior to being on the cover, so I'm really honoured. You know what, like it's funny how different people have perceptions of different people. So, you know, some people might see me on a magazine and they think I'm a model or a brand ambassador, and some people might see the property side and therefore think that that's my interest. So I think, I think if you're true to yourself, and that's all that matters, and then everyone's perception is different. So that's cool with me. But I think it diversifies my life, like everything, and it keeps it very interesting.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. You're just guessing, it's very exciting.
Oh, no, I mean for me, I just mean like it keeps an interesting life.
Yeah. So in terms of the main characteristics of being an entrepreneur, is it that you need to be able to take risks or fail fast, or what is it, or just, you know, have an unwavering self-belief, or what are the main things that work for you?
It's hard to say because no one really thinks of themselves as an entrepreneur when they start out.
You're
so humble. No, I never really thought of it. That would be a dream to be called that. Like to have your name and then to have entrepreneur underneath. That's what I class as success in a way. But I think, you know, I think it's just about taking risks. Mm. So if you're a risk taker, but on the other hand, I can be conservative within that. So you have to sort of weigh up what the risks are. So and just taking a chance, I guess, and really believing in yourself. But some days are hard, like some days you might doubt yourself and you really have to sort of step forward in a way.
Yeah.
Sort of put all of the doubt behind you.
Yeah, I know that.
Everybody has those days where you're like, oh my god, have I gotten in too far?
Yeah.
Exactly. Step forward.
Yeah, no, that's a fantastic answer. And I think that's one of the things that so many of our readers say. They're kind of like, you know, what does it take to be so confident? How do you become risk averse? And you know, what does success mean to you? So I think that's my next question, and you've kind of answered it, but what does success mean for you, and where next?
I think, you know, success for everyone is different, so but for me personally, I think when you are present and you're content in life, I feel like I'm successful, because then ideas flow and you feel like you've got sort of a safety net with businesses. That's sort of safe, and then you can sort of play. So I feel like I'm successful because I have really respected brands that I work with, and then I've got my own. So and I just feel successful. Like I feel like you can use the word successful when you're talking about yourself. Because you do feel a bit like up yourself.
I don't think you can consider that at all.
But I think when you are respected, so respected by your family and friends, people around you, and
yeah.
Someone,